to this module where I compare an infinite array analysis using a Floquet boundary condition and a finite array analysis using a radiating boundary condition inside of the Ansys HFSS. And from our previous module, we know that a Floquet port is used to define an infinite array, and where each element is both physically and electrically the same. In a finite array model, the elements are also physically the same, but the mutual coupling between the elements, such as the interior element to an edge element or an interior to a corner, is included. And mutual coupling is affected by the boundary conditions and whether it's to its nearest element neighbor or to a supporting structure, as in a cell phone case, or maybe part of the human body, which could be your ear or your hand. Whatever is in its near field, and it affects the radiation pattern as well as the input impedance. So let's go ahead and see what this means by comparing the probe-fed microstrip patch antenna as created from a previous model. And this patching antenna was created using the antenna toolkit and designed to resonate at 3.4 gigahertz, which is for use within a 5G application. And this same physical geometry of that microstrip patch antenna uses a lambda over 2 airbox and is set up as a single element with a radiating boundary condition. The units sell for the Floquet port analysis and also as a 2x2 and a 3x3 finite array. And plotting the reflection coefficient of all four cases, we can see that the resonant frequency of the array is between that single element and that infinite array. And so why is there a difference? Well, the reflection coefficient of the element is dependent on the environment. And one way to show the effect is by plotting the input impedance. So here's the plot of the impedance on a Smith chart. And for the top right corner element of the array is shown for the 2x2 and the 3x3. And the input impedance of the 3x3 array center element is also shown. And you can observe that the top right element is more capacitive, as expected, when it's compared to that input impedance of that center element. And the impedance reflects the parasitics that exist when adding more elements or when changing the boundary conditions. So let's go ahead and plot the mutual coupling of the two arrays. And for that 2x2 array, there's almost 4 dB between the closest neighbor, whereas in that 3x3 array, it's less than 3 dB between its nearest neighbor. And by adding more elements, the gain of the array can approach that of an infinite array, but this is at the expense of more interaction between the elements, the mutual coupling. So let's see what happens to the radiation pattern now. So we need to account for the changes in the polarization due to the reflections. So let's look at both the E and the H plane. And when you compare the plots for both phi equals 0 and 90 degrees, we observe that there is a larger difference when phi equals 90 degrees. This is when we are polarized in the E plane or in the horizontal plane. And in these arrays, the elements are placed in the horizontal plane. So there is more coupling as we add elements. And in this video, the comparison was made with a probe-fed microstrip patch antenna as created by the antenna toolkit using a radiating boundary condition and with an infinite array by changing that radiation boundary condition to a Floquet port in HFSS. In addition, a 2x2 and a 3x3 finite array was also created using that same physical geometry. And it was shown that the resonant frequency of the array was somewhere between that single element and the infinite array. And that was because it was due to mutual coupling that exists between the elements. The plot of the mutual coupling was shown, and detailing between that corner element and that center element on that 3x3 array observed. The radiation patterns of the variations were also shown. Again, the mutual coupling effects of the array resulted in a change in the overall antenna radiation pattern. So thank you for watching this video. And if you want to see more videos like this, either on the topic of antennas or any Ansys HFSS topics or any Ansys simulation tools, visit, subscribe, and share our channel, ansys.com/courses today.